utterly tired of wading through a sea of social media banter on battiyan bujhao and taliya bujhao, let me try and give you something a little hatke to talk about. Because at a time when the world is literally panicking about an impending recession, I have a gentleman with me who's planning to start an agency. He's a known face in the advertising circles. Let me introduce him. Abhik Santara, ex-president of Ogilvy, Mumbai and Kolkata. Hi, Abhik.
Hi, how are you, Neeta?
Great, how are you doing?
Very nice, very nice. It's wonderful.
So what you're doing is really courageous. Tell us about the story of starting an agency in the times of COVID-19.
Yeah, I think this is not how we have planned it. But I think now that it has happened, we are not taking a step back and we are very gung-ho about it, actually. So, we have been planning to launch this for around 5-6 months now, okay? Unfortunately, we are already at a time when the business sentiments are not at an all-time high. But having said this, I think these uncertain times makes our reasons even stronger. The market is going to get reset. You know, the new world order of marketing is going to be something very different from what it used to be. And hopefully the offering that we have on the table is at the right time. I think there will be a greater need for a nimble, digital-first, full-service brand agency which can marry all ends of the communication funnel from awareness to performance. So I am not really worried.
Okay. But, it's a known fact that right now clients are cutting costs majorly, especially advertising spends. So how do you at such a point plan to earn some clients and literally set the ball rolling in favor of your agency?
Yeah. So the importance of communication to deliver business ROIs will be of paramount importance now. So the marketeers, businesses will be very impatient to deliver immediate results through any kind of communication efforts that they will be putting in. But at the same time, creating the long-term brand equity cannot be ignored. So that's where, our model comes very handy, because what we plan to do is to create that long-term brand equity for clients without being ignorant of how it should be delivering immediate business results. So I think we're, rightly poised to do that.
Okay. And also tell us a little more about Atom. What will be the different areas of expertise and how will you be different from other agencies?
So we are a digital first brand agency, okay? And our team is respectful and experienced to deliver solutions which impacts long-term brand equity and who understands and respects the modern day consumer journeys. So, the difference is we are not driven by the ambition alone. We are not learning on the job and we are not forced or promoted to become digital mainline or media one fine day. All of us, the leadership team in particular, we have all who have come together, we have a massive collective experience of having done work in these areas. And the diversity is our strength and working without silos is going to be our offering. Because, we are not here because we think we can do, but because of what we have done in the past. So we have a very healthy mix of brand planners who know how to crunch media data. We have creative leaders who are digital natives. We have the content writers who understand the engagement metrics. We have the performance team who have actually mastered business ROIs. And we have the account managers who have worked across various spectrums of the communication business. So that's going to be the USP of Atom, that the unification in the diverse team set, a team that we have, is going to be the biggest offering that we can talk about with the clients.
Yeah, and you spoke about the team. Let's hear who are the people you've coached.
No, I don't think that's the right word. But it's been very difficult for finding the people who are not driven by only the intent or the ambition, but to find people who have the hybrid experience to have done brand building work and also delivered the necessary success in the digital landscape. So it's been a great, but I have been very, very fortunate. I found the biggest mentor that I have, Chanchalda, who has been a serial entrepreneur who has who has been very respected in the field of marketing, experiential marketing field, and getting the creative leaders in place. I think Yash, who is the NCD of Atom, and Ananda, who is the another NCD of Atom, we met at the right time, you know, and it was love at first sight, frankly. We just felt that, you know, each one of us bring that individual experience, which collectively can really create magic. And that's it. So when we decided 4 months back, we knew exactly this is how we need to form the team. You know, after that, all the meetings that we had over lots of beers and lots of whiskeys was primarily to find the other set of the second level of people who comes with a similar kind of background, experiences, and the ambition. So we have people who is coming from content field, people who are coming from, you know, completely data field, people who are coming from media, you know. So we have a very, but all of them are hybrid. So we are not getting people who have done only one kind of work or only one kind of discipline. So very difficult, but we have managed to successfully do that, I think.
Fabulous. You're starting at a very turbulent time, but you know, once the market normalizes, what kind of unique challenges do you see or your agency facing? And there are a lot of stalwarts out there who have already started and established their own agencies. So what kind of competition do you foresee there?
No, I think the new hybrid model agencies, which will probably be, you know, taking birth after the COVID era, are going to be the real interesting competition to have. And I would not see that as a competition. I would rather see them as the great thing that this industry badly needs. If we have these kind of models coming up quickly for the market, marketeers will evolve. Agency as an industry will evolve. The talent pool will evolve. So I'm really looking forward for those kind of models to come as soon as possible. And there are very respected names who are going to be launching. And I really look forward to learning from them.
Fabulous. Thanks a lot for speaking to us, Abhik. And we're hoping to see some great work from the first agency to have launched in the times of COVID.
Is that a challenge?
That tagline speaks.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you very much for the word of encouragement. And let's see where it goes. I'm sure things will be fine.
All the very best. And thank you so much, Abhik.
Thank you very much. God bless.